Howdy folks, Kel here. Well, I thought I would do a review of one of my favorite pipe tobaccos. You know, the actual notes in the tobacco are going to come a little bit later on in the video. So if you just looking for the tasting notes and skip forward, we're going to do a few other things too that most I think you will appreciate. First of all, I'm going to show you the pipe it's going to go in. This is a Chiacopo bent sandblast. I think it's real pretty. I don't know if it's going to showing the camera very well. We'll see. I got my camera set to automatically focus. I don't know if it's going to do it or not. But I got this on eBay. I got a good deal on it, but then I got it and there was a couple little spots inside which were kind of like burn spots. And I wrote the guy back and said, hey, you know, you said it was almost like new, but it's got these burn spots. And I thought maybe he'd give me a little discount. You know, honestly, I thought, you know, but I also just wanted to know, you know, you should really. I wasn't going to give him negative feedback. I told him that. I wouldn't. But anyway, he said, oh, I'm sorry. He said, here's a full refund. I said, well, you don't have to give me a full refund. He said, no, it's okay. It's all right. I think this pipe was, I said before in the video, I think it was maybe some pipe that was given to him or left in the house or something. I'm not sure, really. But it's really a fine pipe. I really like it. And I've always felt bad. I've never paid anything for it. I got it for free, oddly enough. But there's the pipe. What we're reviewing today is Wilke pipe tobacco. Now, this used to be made by a lady who own Pipeworks and Wilke Pipe Tobacco Company, and they would restore, her and her husband restored pipes and sold pipes, but also sold tobacco and blended their own tobacco. Now, I guess thanks to the government creating all these new tobacco laws, she stopped making her own tobacco, and she sold that part of the business to someone else. So now it's just Wilke Pipe Tobacco, and I'll put a link in the description there. The pipe tobacco in question is 191, which used to say on her website, I think this was patterned after. You can see it in there. Focus anything like that? I don't know. It's a black Cavendish. Here, I'll read what it says about it. But this was supposedly the tobacco that Sherlock Holmes smoked from the books. I don't know how they figured that out, but it's kind of supposed to be like that. It's a vanilla tobacco. Natural flavors of vanilla beans, Vermont honey, Virginia's, Kentucky Burley, three toasted black Cavendishes, which is not a kind of tobacco, but a way of curing tobacco, by the way. Mild, slow burning, and it's their most popular tobacco. It's not cheap. It's gone up quite a bit since the government made that rule, and since he sold it, it is not cheap. It was like $67 for a pound of this stuff, which is not cheap. But it is beautiful stuff. Well, if you can see it here, it is beautiful stuff. It's gorgeous. It's a gorgeous tobacco. I don't know if you can see it. I don't want to have it all on the floor. Anyway, and I'm going to probably buy a pound of it soon. I had some. I bought a pound for my son several years ago. He liked it really well. He actually gifted this back to me, and I realized after he did that I actually have some left. I've got a little jar of this. And this is my little Kern jar, which I like a little Kern jars for storing tobacco. This is my only small one. I actually cobbed this from a relative. A relative makes this really nice jam, and they sent us some. And I stole the jar. I cobbed it. It was so cute. The worst part is, they don't even know I stole it from them. But it is a nice little jar. Anyway, so enough of that. So what we're going to do is, I'm going to show you how I pack this stuff too. It's part of the video. What I'm going to do is, I would do this with my fingers if I could, do it without dropping tobacco. I'm just going to put some in like that, and then I'm going to tap the side like this. Just going to tap the side to get it kind of settle down a bit. I'm not going to press into it. I'm not going to pack it, so to speak. Someone will call this the sprinkle method. I'm just going to drop it in there, basically. Now I will kind of even out the top a little bit because I don't like having. I like to keep my tobacco. I like to pack my tobacco so it's about a quarter inch from the top of the pipe rim. That way I don't burn my pipe rim. I like my pipes looking really nice, and that helps do that. Look at that big chunk in there. It's very chunky stuff. Very chunky. I will just, lightly. It's so lightly. It's very just lightly touch the tobacco once it's in there. Otherwise, I'm just putting in and tapping it. And that's it. That's all I'm doing for packing. I did this the other day, and it worked very well with this tobacco. So you may find that will work well for you as well. Turn dryer sitting on there. Okay. I've got my Calibri Conaut 2 pipe lighter. Let's see if that's going to work today. I think I turned it down the other day, all the way down. Okay. And we'll just light her up. I'm gonna light the top part real quick here. I think some calls it a false light. Kind of like a false enlightenment in Zen. And I'll just lightly press down the tobacco that's raised up, which will do, really lightly. I don't want to pack this. I don't want it being packed. I want it just to be sitting in there. This is a vanilla tobacco, is what it is, basically. And it may be the best vanilla tobacco I've ever had. I'm very fond of vanilla tobaccos. I think, really, in retrospect, thinking back on all my pipe smoking from years and years ago, I think vanilla is my favorite tobacco, my favorite flavor of tobacco. It's an aromatic, by the way. I should have mentioned that. And it's nice. It's very nice. It's very, very nice. Got a nice flavor. You see, it gives you really billows of white smoke. The only thing about this tobacco is it's virtually no tongue bite whatsoever. I haven't had any tongue bite with it, and I'm susceptible to tongue bites, so if the tobacco bites, I'll know it. But very flavorful, very nice. I found. But even once I've tipped the ashes out a few times, top ash, and gotten rid of that, as I continue smoking the pipe, I found that it will actually still have a nice flavor. I actually like the taste of ash to some degree, but if you don't tip, you got to tip your ashes. I'll make a video about that. But I find even when I've smoked it down to the bottom of the bowl, it still has flavor, which is nice. Some pipe tobacco is like gum. You chew gum for a few minutes and the flavor's all gone, Some pipe tobacco is like that. Especially a cherry pipe tobacco. I used to be a big, very, very fond of cherry pipe tobacco. But cherry pipe tobacco, what I find is usually the first light is really, really nice. It's just wonderful. But after a few minutes or when the bowl's halfway through or whatever, the flavor kind of goes away. All you got left is kind of a tobacco taste, and the flavor's gone. This tends to keep the flavor throughout the bowl, which is nice. And if you tip the ashes out and get the ashy flavor out, keep doing that about two or three times as you smoke the pipe. The other thing is just a mild tobacco. It's I think it's got good flavor, but it is a mild, nice tasting tobacco. And if you YouTubers are working with the new smell-o-vision that YouTube has, where you can hook the device up to your computer that will give off scents, you can smell this tobacco. It's got a good room note. For the rest of you cheapskates who refuse to buy the smell-o-vision device, well, it does have a good room. You won't be able to smell like others can, but it does have a nice room gnome. Pornhub's coming out with a device which is very similar to Smell-O-Vision, but it's called Feel-O-Vision. It also looks very different. It has a long cord.
Why do you have to ruin a good video game by being naughty?
Very nice though, and I highly recommend it. It is pricey, you know, but I was looking at some Cornell and Deal bulk tobacco the other day too, and it's up there about the same price, you know. Like anything in the world that's rare, you know, there's not a lot of this stuff around. It's made by one person, you know. Not a huge corporation, you know. This guy probably, and I'm sure the guy who owns it mixes it himself the way the lady who used to own it did. Anything like that that's rare is going to be a bit more expensive. It's just the way it goes. You know, just how it is. You know, rare cars, rare whatever. You know, it's going to be more expensive. But anyway, that's it, I guess. I will say this. The Chiracapo pipe has the coral dot with the sterling silver around it rather than just the coral dot. In the old days, they had just a coral dot. Then I think they went to this. And then they went to a silver J, which is for Giacomo. Sir Giacomo. Anyway, yeah, Giacomo. And these are older ones, I guess. I think for a while they made both coral dots and they made ones with silver J, and the coral dots weren't quite as expensive, maybe, I'm not sure. And initially they all had coral dots, and I'm not sure when the coral dot with the sterling silver around it became a thing. I think that's sterling silver. Now, you know, most of their pipes have the J, unless they're the Geppetto series, which has a little picture of a Pinocchio or something. I'm not sure what that is. It's a little silver Pinocchio. But anyway, well, there it is. There's the review. I highly recommend it. I'll try to remember to put a link to it, to Wilke Pipe Tobacco down there. It's like $67, I think it is, plus shipping, like $7, $8 shipping. So it's not cheap. But you can buy, that's by a pound. You can buy, you know, a few ounces of it to try it. So, and I do recommend it. It's nice. It's one of the best vanilla tobaccos I've ever smoked. I'm thinking about ordering a pound of it. I've got this left, and I've got another container left. I'm thinking about ordering a pound of this for myself. Again, another pound, you know, just for me. So, well, that's it. Hope you enjoyed the review. There's the pipe. Here's me. You know, thanks for watching. You might check out my Patreon below. Please click subscribe and click the little bell. Maybe also links down below to JR's cigars or something like that. Or, you know, an affiliate link if you click on those. And buy something there, they'll give me a little piece. I don't know if I'll have that there or not. We'll see in time. But thanks for watching. I hope you're enjoying your life and your pipes. And this is Kelson. Goodbye, and I'll talk to you later.